The next measure on the agenda, Senate Bill 911, Senate Draft 1. By the way, I will admit, I've got everyone, I think, in support. I've got one group that testified in opposition, but I'm looking at the three pages. I've got pretty much universal support except for that one group that opposed. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. I'm Dr. Kathleen Catt. I'm the current medical director for Hilo Medical Center. I'm also a practicing emergency physician. I've been there for 15 years. I've been hired as medical director for physician hiring, recruitment and retaining physicians. So we have recruited three interventional cardiologists for this program. The first one's here. He's already doing procedures and is training our staff and getting our hospital prepared for the arrival of Dr. Wyatt, who's coming in June. And then we'll be able to have twice as much services provided to our community. And then Dr. Smith is coming in August. So by August, we're going to have 24/7 availability of the cardiology, interventional cardiology services. So I thank you so much for your support. Our community is, it's really exciting. Everybody is abuzz about it. And the whole hospital's working very hard to create a very comprehensive and safe program. We're meeting very regularly, and it's very exciting, and I really want to thank the legislature for supporting us. It's pivotal right now. It's happening, and just I think a little bit more support, and we're going to be able to hopefully be able to have this thing take care of itself and provide these services for a long time. The first guy we hired is a little older. He's probably going to only work for another 10 years, but the next two guys that are coming are both in their 30s, have young families, and hope they'll stay here for their careers. So it's very exciting.
Thank you, Doctor.
Hi, my name is Rebecca Moore, and I'm the Stroke and STEMI Coordinator at Hilo Medical Center.
Thank you.
In my occupation, time and time again, I've had to push the TNK medication, which is the heart attack medication. It's a clot buster. And we have to airlift those patients over to Oahu for a higher level of care. And time again, I've had to watch people wait hours, days to get a bed, for the flight crew to show up, and some are too unstable to even make the flight. And I've had to see kids say goodbye to their parents because they knew that they weren't going to make it. We need this bill to pass. We need 24/7 cardiac interventions at our hospital. I don't want to see another patient die in our ER because we're not able to offer what Queens is able to offer. So thank you.
Thanks, Ms. Moore. And thank you, Doctor. Appreciate you being here. Okay, thank you. Anyone else wishing to testify on Senate Bill 911, Senate Draft 1?